Yes, good afternoon, children. In the morning, we started the chapter's text questions discussion, the Browning version. We had discussed hardly one or two questions, and I'll be continuing with the same discussion. Second question is, does Frank seem to encourage Taplow's comments on Crocker Harris? And we had discussed that yes, Frank actually is encouraging Taplow's comments on Crocker Harris. Because he's the kind of fellow who wants to know like how Taplow is able to exert such kind of influence upon his students. He comes to know that Crocker Harris does not beat his students. He does not use corporal punishment to discipline the students. But even then, the students listen to him and obey him and are very sincere towards him. And he wants to know like how come Crocker Harris is able to exert influence upon his students. So he wants to know his like how he works. And moreover, he also wants to know if Crocker Harris involves himself in dishonest practices like leaking the result beforehand or like beating children or the other things through which he would come to know a lot about the school or especially about Crocker Harris. Okay, so third question is like, what do you gather? Okay, second question, you people can add more examples. How can you say that Frank seems to encourage Taplow's comments on Crocker Harris? So you are welcome. You can give examples to prove this point. Yes, raise hand if you want to give answer. Yes, raise hand if you want to give example. Yes. I said raise hand if you want to give example. Very less attendance. Yes. Yes, Pragati, give examples to prove this point.
Yes, ma'am, it can be said that Frank seems to encourage Taplow's comments upon Crocker Harris because he doesn't interrupt. He also takes pleasure when Taplow makes comments about his Greek teacher. But he should have interrupted him and discouraged him from doing so. Frank is a person who takes pleasure in drawing out information, as well as all the details about other teachers. And he also wants to know about the attitude of teachers towards students.
Yes, you can also give example like when this boy Taplow mimicked his teacher, then second time he asked him to do that, where he
he also enjoys the moment when he mimics his teacher Mr. Crocker Harris in a throaty voice.
Yes, so he encourages him to do this more, right? Okay, so third question now. Okay, Pragati, well done. What do you gather about Crocker Harris from the play? The most important thing. So we have not seen Crocker Harris. We did not meet him. Yes, Pragati?
Ma'am, from the play, we come to know that Crocker Harris has been portrayed as a man of principles. He is an honest teacher. He remains very fair while grading his students and doesn't impart them any advantage if they are supposed to do extra work. He is concerned about his students' loss because we come to know about this from an incident that happened with Taplow when he had to suffer a loss due to his absence in school when he fell ill. In order to compensate that loss, Crocker Harris called him to the school in order to give him extra work. We also come to know about Crocker Harris that he doesn't like being liked, due to which he has been called as a person who is hardly a human. Apart from this, he also respects the criterion laid out regarding the result declaration because he doesn't leak the result beforehand.
Yes. So all these examples point out one thing only, that he is a man of principles, very honest in his dealings, and above all, he is the one who doesn't believe in flattery or pampering the students for his own good. Okay, so that, yes, Kavya was also raising hand. Kavya, yes.
Yes, ma'am. Mr. Crocker Harris is a middle-aged schoolmaster. He's quite reserved. He follows rules very strictly. He doesn't leak the results like other masters before they are announced. He's a very kind of conscious of his duty, and he never spare a child who absents himself. He also gives extra work to his students even on the last day of the term.
Yes, that's right. And very fair, even if that, even when he has called the student to do some extra work, even the student knows that he would not get any advantage of doing extra work, because he knows that the teacher is the one who is very, very very honest and a man of principles, and he would not grant him an extra mark, more or maybe less, but not more, right? So this is what the students also, students have great faith in him. Students believe in his integrity of character. Okay, so now there is talking about teachers among friends. Discuss with your partners talking about teachers among friends. Like, this is something, a very, very rampant activity among students. Students usually discuss their teachers among each other. So how far is this a normal practice, or how far is this wrong practice? Is it fair to discuss the teachers among friends? If yes, why? If no, why? Or you can also mention, like, why you people discuss teachers among friends? So what are usually the purposes? Yes, it's a discussion round. So, yeah, it's a universal fact. It's not that we people were also students. So, yes, many a times the students discuss the teachers. So, what are usually the reasons for that? Let it be a discussion round. So, you can discuss this. I have already unmuted you. Yes, Kavya, roll number 25.
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, it is very common among the students to talk about their teachers. Students easily have capacity to analyze a kind of quality of the teachers. Students even see that if a teacher is well-dressed, it is always appreciated by students. If one pays attention to the comment of student, one could easily include that it is an honest or teacher, yeah, who knows him or her.
Okay. The reason, according to you, that the children discuss the student, the students discuss their teachers for their dress up sense, or for their concern.
Teaching sense, kind of.
Teaching sense or their concern, right? Okay. Who else will speak up? Raise hands. It's your discussion part only. Yes, anyone else who wants to speak up? Kindly raise hand. It's an interactive session. Yes, come on. Yes, Pragati.
Ma'am, it is a well-known fact that discussion brings about many points. We come to know about many aspects about a particular topic when we discuss things among our friends or our peer groups. Therefore, when teachers are discussed among friends by the students, it actually impacts in a positive way. It has a good impact because sometimes a person thinks that a particular aspect about the teacher is wrong. Whereas when some other person tries to portray it as a positive fact, and we come to know that there are a lot of positive facts about the teacher also.
Yeah, you are right. So that is a fact, like discussions always, result in positive way also. They are not always negative. So whenever there is a discussion, you always come to know about the positive things also and negative things also. So the things must be discussed out, yes. Anything else, Pragati?
Yes, ma'am. All in all, it broadens our perspective only.
Yes. Yes, well done, Pragati. Anyone else? It's not about the question is not just about discussion of teachers. The thing is that you have to justify what makes a student discuss the teachers. It's not about justification. It's what you discuss. You can raise hand if you are interested to say something about this topic. Yes, come on. Okay, now next topic is the manner you adopt when you talk about a teacher to other teachers. Discuss how you discuss the manner you adopt when you talk about a teacher to other teachers. What manner you adopt then? Do you become, do you remain wise, or do you become nonsense while discussing a teacher with your friends, or what? It's the manner which matters. Discussion is never bad. The purpose is, the thing is how you talk about your teachers. How you talk is more important. Okay, again, Pragati and Kavya, no one else. Only two students are taking part in discussion. What about others? What about others? Should only two children participate in the discussion? Let me ask the talkative children, those who are very talkative, those who talk a lot. Yes, all of you talk a lot always. So what mannerism you adopt then? Or third question is, reading plays is more interesting than studying science. Let us discuss this question. In this play, you people read out that this man, this boy, Taplow, told his science teacher that science is more interesting than that play, Agamemnon. So do you think reading of the play is more important, is more interesting than studying science? What do you say about it? Discuss it. Yes. Now this topic you can all discuss openly. Okay, let's start with Pragati. Yes, Pragati.
Ma'am, reading plays actually presents an idea about literature, and studying science is somehow fact-based, but also interesting. We can actually come to know that reading plays and reading literature while studying science actually leads to a holistic development of the person. Therefore, it completely depends upon the person whether reading play is interesting or studying science is more interesting.
Yeah, you're right, Pragati. It's about the holistic development of a person. Some people, those who are the scientists, they are equally interested in reading literature also. It's not that the scientists don't do literature. Scientists don't like literature. Abdul Kalam,
because it gives rise to a multidimensional personality.
Yes, you're very right. Very good point you raised, that reading literature makes you an enlightened person. Okay, it makes you read life also, because life is not, you cannot separate life from science. Okay, if you're a scientist, you're also a human being. So literature is what life. Literature is life. So reading literature is something which enriches your life, which enriches your experiences. It gives you more, it broadens your outlook. It gives you the wings. So reading makes you an enriched person, actually. The point is not like whether science is more interesting or whether reading the play or fiction is more interesting. The point is like both of them have their own aspects. So it's not comparable, actually. Okay, if you are without science also, you cannot enjoy life. Okay, science is what? Fact-based. Okay, science science makes life rich, but literature enriches you as a person also. Right? Yes, anyone else? Okay, only Kavya, Pragati. No one else is interested in discussion? This is a very fair topic. You can all speak up. You can all tell me, like, why don't you like reading literature? Why you like only science? It's not that I would say it's wrong. Whatever your view is, you can mention that. Yes, Kavya, speak up. Kavya, yes.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, reading plays has always been kind of fascinating than studying facts. Moreover, reading plays helps in develop creativity. But on the other hand, if we see science only deals with facts. But science is about also observing the facts that are already known. So that's why reading plays is more interesting.
Okay. Anyone else? Yes, anyone else? No? Okay, when you are not taking part in the discussion, it's okay then. Only two children are doing the discussion. So yes, children, then there are words. So there are, like, you have to give one word for all these words. Do it on your own. Then based on the text, enact your own version of the play. Work in pairs. Okay. We can give you some project later on. Okay. So prepare this chapter thoroughly today. Okay. And whatever these three questions were, discussion-based questions, you can be asked to write, you can be asked to ask these kinds of things for write-ups also. The point is your concept should be clear upon these things, whether reading plays is more important than studying science. So prepare, write this topic in your fair notebook today. Reading plays is more interesting than studying science. Let it be a debate. Write a debate on this. You may agree with this, you may not agree with this, your wish. So debate, reading plays is more interesting than studying science. Okay, apart from these three questions of the top, understanding the text, you have to prepare the whole chapter from MCQ point of view or from the long questions or short questions point of view. Okay, so be prepared. I guess now I feel like leaving the class because we can start up the new topic from tomorrow. Tomorrow in the morning, we'll start a new topic, maybe some writing skill again. Or maybe a chapter also.